नमो तस्य भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्य। नमो तस्य भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्य। नमो तस्य भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्य। ओके, सो लास्ट वीक वी फिनिश्ड थर्ड चैप्टर समबुद्धि निर्देश। सो डू यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम दैट डिस्कशन और दैट चैप्टर? No questions, right? Okay, then let's move to the next chapter. This is the chapter we just finished, the third chapter of Buddhodaya Samabuddhinidesa. So we learned that there are mainly two types of meters in Buddhodaya. They are Mattabuddhi and Vannabuddhi, right? Mattabuddhi and Vannabuddhi. So in the second chapter we learned about Mattabuddhi versus first chapter was an introductory chapter, and then second chapter was about Mattabuddhi versus, and this third chapter and fourth chapter and then fifth chapter, these three chapters are for Vannabuddhi meters. So in Vannabuddhi also there are three types: Samabuddhi, Addha Samabuddhi, and Visamabuddhi. So what we finished is Samabuddhi. So there were verses up to 22 syllable verse, right? 22 syllable verse. 22 syllable verse was named as Akati, as you see here. So today we are moving to fourth chapter, Addha Samabuddhi Nidesa. So Addha means half, right? Half. Sama means similar. So Addha Sama means halfly similar. That means in the verse, like in the Samabuddhi verses, all the four lines were similar with each other. All the four lines had similar number of letters and similar groups and Garu Lahu. So here Addha Samabuddhi means only two lines are similar with each other. First line is similar with the third line, and second line is similar with fourth line. So one and three are similar, two and four are similar. So because of that, we call Addha Samabuddhi. We call them Addha Samabuddhi. So since one and three are same and two and four are same, only one and two are shown here. First line and second line are shown. Third and fourth lines are not shown. So third line should be composed as same as the first line. And the fourth line should be composed as same as the second line, right? That is how Addha Samabuddhi verses are. So you can see here there are all 11 verses starting from 107 to 117. There are 11 verses. So we are going to learn about these 11 verses today. So Addha Samabuddhi Nideso, the description of the half similar line meters. Addha Sama, half similar line, right? Lines are half similar. Nidesa description. So first verse is Upachitta. Upachitta. So in the previous section, in the previous chapter, there were generic names, right? There were verse names and also generic names, but here we only have verse names, no generic names here. Totally there are 11 verses, so there are 11 names given for them. That's all. So the first verse is Upachitta, Upachitta verse, Upachitta. Visame yadi sa salaga same bhattayato garuka upachittang विषमे यदि सा सलगा समे भत्तयतो गरुका उपचित्तं. So here first line ends at ends after same. Visame yadi sa salaga same. After same the first line ends. Then second line starts from bhatteyato. Bhatteyato garuka upachittam. So the meaning is given as another thing about these verses is that there are no word breaks in these verses. There are no word breaks because lines are not much long. These lines are very similar with the lines we met in the second chapter in Vannavutti Nidesa. Very similar with those lines. So in Vannavutti Nidesa also we rarely found word breaks. Because lines are not so long. So here also, word breaks are not there. Word breaks are not there. So the meaning of this verse is, in the odd lines, if there are two saganas, another sagana, light syllable and heavy syllable, and if they even after three baganas, two heavy syllables, that is called as upachitta. So that is the rough meaning of this verse. Visame, we already know this term, visama. Visama means not similar, right? So here it refers to odd numbers. Odd numbers. Visama means odd numbers, not similar numbers. Like when you divide a number by two, if you get answer as zero, that means you can divide that number by numbers similarly, number to similar, two similar parts. So you call it sama number. But when you divide it by two, if one remains, then that number cannot be divided into two parts similarly. So we call that number visama. So here, odd numbers are called as visama, and even numbers like 2, 4, 6, 8 are called as sama. So likewise, odd lines that mean first line and third line, 1 and 3 are called as visama, and even lines, that means 2 and 4 are called as sama. So here visame means in visama lines, in odd lines. Actually, it's in singular, but like in odd line, there are two odd lines in a verse. When you say in odd line, then you have to take both lines, both odd lines. So visame in the odd line, yadi, if there are sa salaga, sa is in plural form, so here it is translated as two saganas, so two saganas should be there, and again salaga sagana lahu garu should be there. Two saganas sagana lahu garu means there should be three saganas and lahu garu in the visama lines, odd lines. Same. In summer line, there should be bhattayato garuka. Bhattayato, bha means bhagana, thaya means three, right? Triad it was. Here it is translated as three bhaganas, but in some places it was translated as triad. Thaya means collection of three, right? Thaya, tinnan samuho, thayang. So thaya means three or triad. So bhattaya means three bhaganas. Bhattaya to, after three bhaganas, garuka, there should be two heavy syllables, because garuka is in plural form. There should be two heavy syllables after three bhaganas. Upachittang, va is a euphonic consonant. It has no meaning. Va is euphonic. Upachitta is the name of the verse. So in the odd lines, there should be three saganas and then lahu garu. In even lines, there should be three bhaganas and then two heavy syllables. So you can clearly see that the groups are totally, completely different. Here they are three saganas, but here they are three bhaganas. And then here, Lahu and Garu, two syllables are there at the end. Here also, two syllables are there at the end. They are two heavy syllables. So the number of syllables are same in both lines. Number of syllables are same. Here also, you see in three saganas, there are 12 syllables, right? Nine syllables. There are nine syllables in three saganas. Nine syllables and then lahu garu, that means 11 syllables. So here also three bhaganas, that means nine syllables, and then two heavy syllables, 11. So number of syllables are same in both lines, but group structure is completely different. So let's check for the groups. Visa me is sagana, right? Lahu lahu garu is sagana. Yeah, this sa again sagana. Salaga again sagana. Sa is lahu, me is garu. And yeah, that is the first line. You see no word breaks are there. And then second line, bhattaya is bhagana, right? Bhattaya, because bhat is garu, taya lahu lahu. It is bhagana. To garu again bhagana. Ka bupa again bhagana. Chittang, two heavy syllables. So you can observe all the roles in this verse. So you have to compose the third line as so that it will be similar with this first line, right? Third line will be like exactly like this first line. There should be no differences, exactly similar with this first line. And fourth line should exactly be similar with this second line. So one and three are similar, two and four are similar. So that is upachitta verse. Upachitta verse. So yeah, that's all about this. Another important thing to mention here is that there are no examples for these verses in literature. There are, like, really there can be some examples in like letter literature, but in Pali canon and in other literature there are, like, literally no examples for these verses. Even in the literature written to illustrate these verses shown in Uttode, these Adhyasamavutti verses are not found, rarely found. There are some examples, but rarely found. So because of that, in many verses in Bhante Ananda Jyoti's book also, examples are not shown. So that is Upachitta verse. Are there any questions?
Yeah, hi, Panti.
Yes.
I have a question. This is like a general question about how to compose a good verse, right? So here we can see that there is a euphonic insertion, V, right? So in fact, we don't really need it, right? But I mean, we can just separate these two words, because garuka and then upachitang, I mean, there's nothing wrong with that, right? But then here there is put a V in here to combine these two words. Is that like it's not a rule, but it's like a rule of thumb to make a verse a good verse, in a sense that when we have two vowels coming together, we need to have to do the euphonic somehow to make it a good verse, Pante?
There is not such a rule, but where euphonic consonant should be inserted, there you should insert. So here it is vowel U is following, right? Vowel U is following. So in Rupa Siddhi, maybe you can remember there is like in under the sutta, Yava Madana Tarala Chagama, Va is often inserted when Avanna and Ukara are following. It's like Avan Ukare Su. Avanna, avanna means a and a, short and long a. And then ukara, vowel u. When they are following, va is often in many examples, not everywhere actually, not everywhere, but va is inserted like in, let's say, there is a example in Rupa Siddhi, Migi Bhanta Vudikkati. In a verse, Migi Bhanta Vudikkati. That is the example given in Rupa Siddhi. So Migi Bhanta Udikkati. It is Udikkati, but Va is inserted and it becomes Vudikkati. So when euphonic consonants can be inserted according to grammatical rules, they should be inserted in such places. So you cannot, of course, insert everywhere where you think like where you feel like inserting, but when it is like when there are places where often these euphonic consonants are inserted, then it is good to insert them. So here you can of course keep it without inserting va. Garuka upachitta, nothing happens, like it is still correct. So that's also correct, but after inserting also, considerable difference hasn't happened, and it becomes really easier to read, because maybe the reason to insert va before u is that it makes it easier to read upachitta and then upachitta. So in such places they should be inserted, but cannot insert everywhere.
So is it like this is one of the suggestions that Subodha Lankara will suggest from the
euphonic consonants?
Yes. Do we have like that kind of suggestion in Subodha Lankara?
No, there is not. As I can remember, there is not such a suggestion. Usually, one thing is there are like you cannot insert words, any word, even one, like words with one letter, without a meaning, without a purpose.
Nice.
That rule is there in Subodha Lankara. Like some people, when they compose verses, they often insert cha or va or some pana or such particles here and there, just to fill the syllable count. So that is not good.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay. It's like Napadapura Nathaya Padang Yojaya Kathachi. That is a verse. Padapura Nathaya. Just to fill the line, you should not insert pada, insert words or terms here and there. But this euphonic, as I can remember, there was no mentioning about euphonic sounds. Yeah, but when it is suitable to insert euphonic consonants according to grammatical rules or according to philology, then it is good to insert them, because those rules are made in order to make the language more nice, right? More beautiful. Yeah,
then of course it can make the composer to look knowledgeable and
yeah. Yes. Then another thing is that Sayali Punyachari also had a question.
So really, like Dr. Ryan's question, because you see, we see the Sanskrit part, they also, the Uttara and Nakara, they also insert U, so Va, Va, you see there?
Yes, they are also Va is there.
I think it's because of the direct take from there.
Yeah, that is Probably that is the reason. But when you compose also, you can insert these euphonic sounds when it is suitable to insert.
Because in Sanskrit, there, if you don't insert wa, so there will be go to sandhi. So sandhi will be changed to o. That means go bajitra. I mean, in Sanskrit part. Or maybe if they keep that, they can become gawa, like that also.
You mean because there is a vowel in the front side and
yes, and
two vowels are there, then there is.
Yeah, yeah. Generally, in Sanskrit, sandhi, right? Yeah, yes. In Sanskrit, they have to go to sandhi.
Yes, that is a very good reason. That is a very good reason. Yes, Pali also that happens, but there can be, I don't know about Sanskrit exactly, but in Pali, there are so many places where two vowels are there without being combined together, right? We call them Pakati Sandhi. We keep them as they are without making Sandhi. So...
But in Sanskrit, they have to go to sandhi because they write in the Devanagari in the same line. So that's why they have to go to sandhi.
Yes.
So like I said before, Vandi, so if I see like the first line and second line the same, and the third line, fourth line the same, so we still consider as the Attasama Udina, or we consider as the Upajati?
We consider as Upajati.
Yeah. We do not consider as Addasama Uddi.
We do not consider as Addasama Uddi. Because Addasama, in the way of Addasama Uddi is, they should be like first and three should be similar, third should be similar, second and fourth should be similar. That is the usual way, that is the like nature of Addasama. I mean, according to Uttode, maybe in other Sanskrit or other prosodies, another explanation can be there. But Uttodaya method is that only these verses are named as Addasama. Otherwise, they are called as Upajati, of course.
Okay, Mani. So my another question is not concerning with this, but it's concerning with the numbers. So in Bali, we have the Visama and Sama. But when we come to like, we see 1.5. So like 1.5, we consider is a Visama or
1.5 should also be considered as Visama, right? Because it cannot be divided into two.
No, Bante. And if the odd or even numbers only happens for whole number, 1.5.
Yes, that is another thing.
Yeah, but I mean, in Bali, how would they see in what kind of word they will represent, like 1.5, like those type of thing?
There are words for 1 and 1.5, 2 and 2.5. For such numbers, there are words like, you know, diadha means 1.5, 1.5, right?
Yes. Sometimes maybe like 1.1 or 1.2. So I'm really confused with the number in the body. So
when you write those numbers in Pali, right?
Yes.
Then maybe you have to, there are no such numbers in Pali. So you have to like write in another way. Like in some places for 2.5, you can say adhena dve, right? Half, two with a half, adhena dve. So you can follow that method and say like tihi dve. That means 2.3 maybe.
Hello, Bate.
Yes.
I think best number we have in Bali, we can see in 33rd chapter in the Sankhya part. So we have that kind of number. Yes, in Balaruma City.
Yes, of course. In Tadita chapter, there are numbers, but they are only for 1.5, 2.5, and 3.5, right? For those three, they yes. are there yes. are numbers. Dhyadha, and Adhatiya. So those three are there in Kachan itself, actually, in Sutta itself. Sutta itself, but other decimal numbers, there is no way to say in Pali. Okay, then another thing is there is a semicolon, right? This one. It is for, it is not for a stop, it is not a word break or something. It is just to show that this is the, like, this part is, this is how I think. There was no mentioning about this, but this should be the reason. This part shows the groups of Visama line. And from here begins this description for Sama line, right? So that is the reason maybe to divide like this. Visama groups are shown here and Sama groups are shown after that. But first line ends here after Same, right? So semicolon is not for a word break or a line break. Okay, let's go to the next verse. Duta majha. Bhattayato yadi ga duta majha. Yadi punareva bhavanti najajya. Bhattayato yadi ga duta majha. Yadi punareva bhavanti najajya. So there is no symbol to show word line breaks in these verses also. So please, if there is difficulty for you to break the line, then please look at these symbols, and here is the line break, right? So you can count the numbers and know the line break, know where is the line break. So the meaning is, if after three bhaganas there are two heavy syllables, and again if there is a nagana, two jaganas and yagana, that is dutamajha. Bhattayato, after three bhaganas, bhattaya, right? Taya means triad, three. So bhattayato, bhattaya means three bhaganas. After three bhaganas, this is ablative, after three bhaganas, yadi, if ga, two heavy syllables should be there. Ga is in plural, so two heavy syllables. After three bhaganas, two heavy syllables are there. That verse is called as dutamajha. And again, yadi punareva, again, there should be punareva. He also writes euphonic, puna and eva, because ra is a place, puna. Is a place where ra should be inserted according to Pali grammar, according to Sanskrit. There is R right after puna, like it is punar in Sanskrit, punar, but in Pali it is puna. So often ra is inserted when a vowel is following. That is why here ra is inserted. Punareva bhavanti najajya, again there should be najajya, nagana, jagana, jagana, and yagana. Four groups should be there. So here there is no mentioning about Sama line or Visama line, but the first description is for Visama line and the second description is for Sama line. Okay, so Bhattaya to, Bhattaya is the first Bhagana, to Yadi is the second Bhagana, Ga Duta is the third Bhagana, Majha are two heavy syllables. Then Naja Jaya should be there. Yadi Pu is Nagana. Na Reva is Jagana. Bhavanti is again Jagana. Naja Jaya is Yagana. Lahu Garu Garu. So here are the groups. No word breaks. So that is Dutamajha verse. No example is given. Are there any questions? No questions. Then let's move to the next verse. Vegavati, Vegavati. Yadi sattitayam garu yuttam, Vegavati yadi bhatta. satitaya ga yadi satitayang garu yuttang vegavati yadi bhattitaya ga yadi if satitayang sa means saga sorry let's read the meaning. If there are three saganas, a triad together with heavy syllable, and if there are three bhaganas, a triad together with two heavy syllables, that is vegavati. So here is a problem. Satitayang, sa means sagana, ti means three, taya means again triad, three. So sati also means three saganas, right? Sati, three saganas. Taya also means three. So this is like the same meaning repeated. However, in the Burmese translation, sati taya, full word was translated as three saganas. But this grammatical problem is there. So we can say that by taya, this sati is again emphasized by the word taya. Sati also means three saganas. Taya also says again that there should be three saganas. So that problem is there. So there should be three saganas, and then garu yuttang, that those three saganas should be with a heavy syllable at the end. That means there are only 10 syllables, right? Three saganas and one garu. Vegavati is the name of the verse. Yadi, if there should be bhatti taya ga, after three bhaganas, there should be ga, two heavy syllables. Two heavy syllables, ga is plural here, that is not ablative. So here also bhatti taya, the same problem is there. Bhatti means three bhaganas, and then taya also means three. In Sanskrit, it is sayuga, saguru, visame, ched, bhaviha, vegavati, yuji, pat, gau. This is only in Pali, right? This is only in Pali. Yes. So let's check for the groups. Yadi sat is sagana. Yadi sat is sagana. Tita yang is again sagana. Then guru yut is again sagana, three saganas. Tang is heavy syllable. Heavy syllable. Yeah, we just finished the first line, right? The second line is vegava is bhagana. Ti yadi is second bhagana. Bhattita is third bhagana. Yaga, two heavy syllables. So this is Vegavati verse. For this also, there are no examples given. Are there any questions?
Yeah, hi, Pante.
Yes.
So I have a question. So why is Satitayang is the, I guess it's the neuter gender. But then Patitaya is the feminine gender.
Yeah. It is not a feminine gender. It's an ablative case. After three bhaganas, two heavy syllables are there.
Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah. Okay. That's right. Okay. Thank you, Bhante.
Okay. So let's move to the next verse. It is Bhaddaviraja. तो जो विषमे रतो गरु चे मसाच का भद्द विराज मिथ गोचे तो जो विषमे रतो गरु चे मसा here try to read it as msa, right? But in Myanmar they read this as masa because it's difficult to read. मसाच का भद्दविराज मिथ गोचे भद्दविराज मिथ गोचे. So meaning is if in the odd lines there is tagana jagana and after ragana a heavy syllable, And if there is magana, sagana, jagana, and two heavy syllables here, we have Bhadda Viraja. That means this verse is called as Bhadda Viraja. To, tagana, jo, jagana, visame, in the visama line, in the odd line, there should be tagana, jagana, rato, and after agana, garu, there should be a heavy syllable, only one heavy syllable, but it is in plural. To protect the meter, it is kept in plural. Yeah, one heavy syllable should be there in the visama line, and then in the summer line, in the even lines, there should be msa, magana, and sagana, chga, jagana, and garu, and then again one heavy syllable. That means two heavy syllables should be there. Bhadda viraja metta should be separated as bhadda virajang. Itha, here it is called as Bhadda Viraja verse. So that means in the visama lines, there should be Thagana, Jagana, Ragana, and one heavy syllable, 10 syllables that means. And then in summer lines, there should be Magana, Sagana, Jagana, and two heavy syllables. That means 11 syllables. To, Jo, Vi is Thagana, Sa, Me, Ra is Jagana. Then to ga ru is ragana, che is the heavy syllable. In the even line, msaj is one heavy syllable, right? Msaj is considered as one heavy syllable. Ga is another heavy syllable. Bhad is heavy syllable. So this is the magana. Msaj, ga, bhad, magana. And then the vira is sagana, ja, met, tha. Is jagana, go is one heavy syllable, che is another heavy syllable. So that is Bhadda Viraja verse. No examples given. Is that clear?
Sorry, Pandey.
Yes.
The last time we learned about the before a context at the beginning of the line should be known as the last syllable. But here, Masa Chuga, is this at the beginning of the line, so we know the light syllable, but here we consider as the heavy syllable. But why here he considered as a heavy syllable, Bante?
Yes, that is a very good question. That is a very good question. In the first chapter, we met the verse. That is what is that verse? Pare pada di sangyoge yo pubbo garu kakkaro lahusa kwachi vinyayo tadudaharanam yatha. When there is pada di sangyoga, when there is a conjunct in the beginning of a line, then in the previous line, the last letter of the previous line is considered as lahu. It is considered as light, kwachi sometimes. So that was there in the introductory chapter. So there, kochi was there, right? Sometimes, only in some places. That happens only in some places. That is why kochi was there. So this is not a common rule. This is not something happens everywhere. This is not something happened commonly. This just happens sometimes in some places. So that is what kochi means in that verse. Lahusa kochi vinyayo. Because in some verses, especially Mattavutti verses, if the last syllable becomes heavy, then the misha count, mora count, change, right? Mora count changes if the last syllable becomes heavy, like in the example we met in the introductory chapter, dasana rasana bhavane nibaddha gedha jinasya anjanata vimhaya janani sanyata. So there sanyata, it is Padanta Garu and also Sangyogadi Garu, because after that Sanyat, there was a word, Kriya, right? Kri. Vimhaya janani sanyata kriyanukam kanuranjayati. So there we considered it as lahu because there should be only 12 moras, only 12 measures. Otherwise, it is not an arya verse. So in such places, rarely we consider that last letter, last syllable of the line as light. So that is not something happens everywhere. That's not a general rule. Okay. So that is why we do not consider this che as lahu. Okay, then let's move to the next verse. It is Ketumati Visame Saja Sagaru Yutta Ketumati Same Bharana Gago Visame Saja Sagaru Yutta Ketumati Same Bharana Gago. Meaning is given as in the odd line Sagana Jagana Sagana together with heavy syllable and in the even. Bhagana, Ragana, Nagana, and two heavy syllables, that is Ketumati. So Visame in odd lines, there should be Sagana, Jagana, Sagana, Garyutta with a heavy syllable. There should be a heavy syllable at the end, one heavy syllable, right? So Sagana, Jagana, Sagana, and one heavy syllable. There are 10 syllables. Ketumati is the name of the verse. Same in even lines, there should be Bharana Ga Go Bhagana Ragana Nagana Ga Garu and then Go again Garu. That means here three groups are there, two heavy syllables are there, 11 syllables altogether. Visame is the Saga first Sagana, Sajasa is the Jagana, Garu Yut is again Sagana, Tha is the heavy syllable. Ketuma is Bhagana, Tisame is Ragana, Bharana is Nagana, Ga, Go are two heavy syllables. So this is Ketumati verse. Yes, are there any questions? No questions. Then let's move to the next verse. Akhyanika. Akhyanika. Akhyanika ta visame jagago jata jagago tu sametha padi. Akhyanika ta visame jagago jata jagago tu sametha padi. So if you have memorized and if you have read the verses in Uttode again and again, now you will probably remember one verse when you read this. Did you remember any verse when you read this? Akhyanikata visame jagago jata jagago tu sametha pade. No? Akhyanikata visame jagago, that is just as same as Indadikata Vajira Jagago, right? In the Vajira verse, that is a verse to be memorized. It is a very nice verse. In the Vajira verse, it is in 11 syllable verses. It is the first verse in 11 syllable verses. In the Vajira, Indadikata Vajira Jagago, you say Akhyanikata Visame Jagago. Jata jagago to sameta pade. So the meaning is Akhyanika has two taganas, jagana and two heavy syllables in the odd lines, and then jagana, tagana, jagana and two heavy syllables in the even lines. Akhyanika is the name of the verse. Tha, tha in plural. So two taganas, visame in odd lines, two taganas should be there. Then jagana and two heavy syllables should be there. Two taganas, jagana and two heavy syllables. So this line is as same as in the Vajira. Inda adhika tha Vajira jagago. Two heavy syllables, jagana and two taganas, jagana and two heavy syllables. was called as Inda Vajira in a Samavutti chapter, Samavutti section. Then the second line, Jata Jaga Go to Sametha Pade. This is the same as Upadika Sava Jata Jaga Go. Upadika Sava Jata Jaga Go. Upenda Vajira verse, right? This is same as Upenda Vajira verse. So Jata Jaga Go Jagana Tagana Jagana Garu Garu. Sameta Pade, Same Atha Pade, after that, like then Atha, then Same Pade in Samapada, there should be Jagana Tagana Jagana Garu and Garu. So the first line is as same as Inda Vajira, second line is as same as Upenda Vajira. Yeah, so let's check it. Akhyani is Tagana, Katavi is again Tagana, Sameja is Jagana, Ga, Go, two heavy syllables. Jataja is Jagana, Ga, Go, two is Tagana, Sameta again Jagana, Pa, De, two heavy syllables. So, yeah, that is Akhyanika verse. Now you can clearly see that Inda Vajira and Upenda Vajira verses are mixed here. So first line and third lines should be Inda Vajira, and second and fourth line should be Upenda Vajira. So this verse can also called as Upajati, right? Upajati. This is also Upajati verse, because Inda Vajira and Upenda Vajira are mixed. This can be called as Upajati verse, but it has a special name called as Akhyanika. You can call Upajati even when there is like first line Inda Vajira and other all three lines are Upenda Vajira. In that case also you can name it Upajati. First line Upenda Vajira, other three lines are Inda Vajira. Still it is Upajati. First, like let's say, first line and third lines are Upenda Vajira. Two and four are Inda Vajira. Still you can call Upajati. But here in Akhyanika, there is a specific rule. First and third should be Inda Vajira. Second and fourth should be Upenda Vajira. Only in that case you call it Akhyanika. So, because it becomes Adda Samavutti. It becomes Adda Samavutti. Yeah, that is Akhyanika verse. And there is an example from, that is not an example. That's not an example. It is a Sanskrit version Shrutabodha. Sanskrit version in Shrutabodha. Yeah, that is Akhyanika. Are there any questions? No questions. Then we are moving to the next verse. It is Viparita Akhyanika. Viparita Akhyanika. That means Akhyanika is reversed. The opposite of Akhyanika. Jata Jagago Visame Sametu Thajo Gagache Viparita Pubba. Jata Jagago Visame Sametu Thajo Gagache Viparita Pubba. Meaning is, if there is Jagana, Tagana, Jagana and two heavy syllables, the odd lines, but in the even, two Taganas, Jagana and two heavy syllables, then that is the reverse of the firm formal meter. So obviously what has been done here is that Upenda Vajira comes to the beginning and then Inda Vajira goes to the other side. First line Upenda Vajira, second line Inda Vajira. So the opposite of Akhyanika. That's why it is called as Viparita Akhyanika. Jata Jaga Go Visame. In Visame line Jata Jaga Go should be there. Same Tu is here. Translated as, where is tu, but here it is translated as but it can also be translated as apart from that, right? Apart from that, tu is often translated as apart from that. Apart from that, the next line. Tha tu taganas jo jagana gaga tu visibas viparita pubba. That means the verse which has the name with viparita in the beginning. So akhyanika should be taken to here. Viparita pubba akhyanika. Viparita pubba akhyanika. That means viparita akhyanika. The word viparita is at the beginning of that name. So viparita pubba means the name is not viparita pubba. It's viparita akhyanika. It's like indadika vajira, right? Then the verse which has the name which has inda at the beginning, that is called as inda vajira. That's not indadika vajira, it's inda vajira. So likewise here, viparita pubba akhyanika, viparita akhyanika. That's it. Let's check for the groups here. Jata ja is jagana, ga go vi is thagana, samesa is again jagana, me tu is two heavy syllables. Tu is obviously light, but we consider it as heavy. Tha jo ga is thagana, ga che vi is again thagana. Then parita is jagana, pubba, two heavy syllables. So this is opposite of akhyanika. Obviously, this verse can also be called as upajati, right? This is also a kind of upajati verse, but we give it a special name called as viparita akhyanika. So please don't be confused with these two lines. There are only two lines. Don't consider this says like Addasama Vutti verses only have two lines. This is just like showing the first two lines, right? In Samavutti, there was only one line in each verse, but we had to repeat that one line four times to compose the verse. So likewise here also only two lines are shown. We have to compose other two lines to fill the verse. So that is Viparita Akhyanika. Are there any questions?
Hi, Pandey.
Yes.
So if we go to page 112, then in fact there are names, specific names for these two verses.
So of course.
Right?
Yes.
So in fact there are two specific names for each of these verses, not just a generic name. And for example, like for the Akhyanika, then it also can be named as Patra.
Yes, you are correct.
Yes.
Akhyanika can also be called as Patra because what Dr. Ayan says is that in under the Upajati verses, we learned that in Sanskrit there are names. There are various names for various upajati possibilities, right? There are various names. Like we in Vuttodaya, we call all those verses as upajati. But when there is Indavajra verse, when the first line is Indavajra and other three lines are Upendavajra, then there was a specific name in Sanskrit. And in Vuttodaya Tika also, as I can remember. So for all the possibilities, there were 16 possibilities. So all those possibilities, there were specific names. So for this possibility also was there, and there was a name for that possibility. So Viparita Akhyanika, the name was Bhadra, right? For the Viparita Akhyanika, name was Bhadra.
Yes.
And for Akhyanika also.
Yes. Hansi.
Hans. Yeah. Opposite, right? For Akhyanika, it is Bhadra, maybe.
Yes.
Yes. Akhyanika, it is Bhadra, according to that classification. And here, for Viparita Akhyanika, the name is Hansi, according to that classification. So under Upajati also, these two verses are there. But in Addasama Vutti chapter, we give them another name, Akhyanika and Viparita Akhyanika. we give them other names. Then let's move to the next verse. Harina Pluta, Harina Pluta. Sasato Salaga Visame Same Nabhara Bhavate Harina Pluta. Sasato Salaga Visame Same Nabhara Bhavate Harina Pluta. If after two saganas there is another sagana, light syllable and heavy syllable in the odd lines, and in the even lines, nagana, two baganas, and ragana, that is Harina Pluta. Sasato, sasato, after two saganas, salaga, again sagana, lahu and garu, and adya, that means three saganas and lahu garu in visame odd lines. Same in even lines, nabhara, nagana, bhagana, bhagana, and ragana adya, that verse is Harina Pluta, that verse is called as Harina Pluta, Harina Pluta. So, in this verse, in the first line, there should be three saganas and two syllables. So there are 11 syllables all together. In the second line, there are four groups. So there should be 12 syllables all together, right? In the first line, 11 syllables, but in the second line, 12 syllables. That means first and third lines, 11 syllables. Second and fourth lines, 12 syllables are there. Sasato is the first sagana, salaga is the second sagana, visame is the third sagana, same is lahu and garu. Nabha is nagana, ra bhava is bhagana, te hari is another bhagana, nap lupta is ragana. So that is Harina Pluta verse. Are there any questions? No questions.
Sorry, Bante.
Yes.
The word Harina Pluta is mean the outline. We have the 11 syllable, and then the even line we have the 12 syllable, right, Bante?
Yes. Yes. Right.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Okay, then we are moving to the next verse. It is Aparavatta. So we are going to finish this chapter today. Aparavatta. Yadi nanara laga naja jara. Yadi cha tada paravatta michati. Yadi nanara laga naja jara. Yadi cha tada paravatta michati. If there are two naganas, ragana, light syllable and heavy syllable in the odd lines, and if there are nagana, two jaganas and ragana in the even lines, then the name Aparavatta is required. Yadi, na, na, ra, laga, nagana, nagana, ragana, lahu and garu are there. If those are there, then naja, jara, yadi, cha. If nagana, jagana, jagana, and ragana also are there. Tada, then at that time, aparavattang icchati. This verse is required, or this verse is maybe liked as aparavattang, aparavatta verse. The name of this verse is aparavatta. So nanara laga is for the odd lines, and naja jara is for the even lines, but both in the odd line of the, in the first line of this verse, yadi nanara laga naja jara. You see, here ends the first line, yadi nanara laga naja jara. However, nanara laga, these rules are for these groups and syllables are for odd lines, and naja jara are for even lines. So let's check it. Yadi na is nagana. Na ra la is second nagana. Ga na ja is ragana. Ja ra is lahu and karu. There should be naja jara, right? Let's check it. Yadicha is nagana na. Tada pa is jagana naja, right? Naja jagana. And then ra vata is again jagana. Mit chati is ragana. Mit chati is ragana because ti is garu, right? Mit chati is ragana. So aparavattang ichchati. It should be separated as aparavattang ichchati. So that is aparavatta verse. Are there any questions? Oh, there is an example for aparavatta verse. One verse is there from Madhuratta Vilasini. Madhuratta Vilasini. And it is said that this is one of the few meters in this section that is in use in the literature. And examples can be found in Venerable Buddha Datta's works and Mahavansa. So it says that in Mahavansa also there are examples for aparavatta verse, right? So this is taken from Madhuratta Vilasini. Usabhavati pure purut. Tame jina vasabho bhagavahi vesabho. Let's check only the first two lines. Nanara laga should be there, right? Usabha is nagana, vatipu is again nagana, repu rut is ragana, tame lahukaru, nanara laga are there. Then naja jara should be there. Jinava is nagana, sabho bha is jagana, gavahi is again bhagana. Vesabhu is pragana, naja jara. So you can observe these rules in that verse. So that is an example for aparavatta verse. Aparavatta verse. Yeah, are there any questions? No. Then we are moving to the next verse. That is Puppitagga. Puppitagga. Visam mupagata nana raya che najaja raga samakecha puppitagga. Visam mupagata nana raya che najaja raga samakecha puppitagga. If two naganas, ragana and yagana, come in the odd lines, and nagana two jaganas, ragana, and heavy syllable in the even, that is puppitagga. Visam upagata, visamang upagata. Upagata. Upagata is the it is kitaka kriya. Like it is the ending. It behaves as the verb, right? Upagata. Nana raya che visamang upagata. If nagana ragana and yagana has reached to visama pada. That means that is the grammatical meaning, right? Visamang upagata, those groups have reached, visama pada. Visamang upagata. If nagana ragana and yagana have reached visama pada, and if nagana, jagana, ragana, and garu are there in samake, in samapada, that verse is called as puppitagga. That verse is called as puppitagga. So nana, raya should be there. Visama is nagana. Mupaga is again nagana, nana. Tha, nana is ragana. Raya, che is yagana. So that is the first line. Second line, there should be najaja raga. Najaja raga should be there. So let's check it. Najaja is nagana. Ragasa is jagana. Makecha is again jagana. Puppitag is ragana. Ga is garu. So, heavy syllable. So this is puppitagga verse. So there is an example for puppitagga verse also. We will come to this this part again. Example from Jinavansa Deepa. Jinavansa Deepa. Niravadhi bhuvanala vala gabhe sucharita mula virulha kitti valli. Sucharita mula virulha kitti valli. So in first line there should be nana raya, right? Nana raya. Nirava is na, dhibhuva is again na, nanara. ra should be there. Na, le, va is ragana. Then le, ga, bhe is yagana. So that is nana, raya. In second line, there should be najaja, raga, najaja, raga. Suchari is nagana. Te, moola is jagana. Virulha is again jagana. Kitti, val is ragana. Li is heavy syllable. So this is actually there are two verses examples for Upitaka. The whole of chapter 19, 50 verses is in this meter. So in Jidamansa Deepa, there are 50 verses in Upitaka meter. So there is one special statement here. Dvayang midang, dvayam midang. Dvayamidang veta liya pabhedo. Dvayamidang veta liya pabhedo. Meaning is this pair, aparavata and puppitagga, are kinds of veta liya. This pair, dvayang, idang dvayang, right? This pair, this dvaya means couple or two, the collection of two, dvayang, dvinnang samuho, dvayang. So these two verses, or this pair of verses, that means this verse, Upitaka verse, and the previous verse, which was aparavatta, right? So this pair here refers to aparavatta verse and Upitaka verse. So these two verses are vetaliya pabhedo. They are kinds of vetaliya. So these two verses are also included in Vetaliya verse. So you can remember Vetaliya verse, that is from the second chapter. In second chapter, there were four types of verse, like four sections, right? In in Mattavuti, there were four sections: Arya Jati, then Geet Jati, Vetaliya Jati, and Matta Samaga Jati. Arya Jati, Geeti Jati, Vetaliya Jati, and Matta Samaka Jati. So there was Vetaliya Jati. So these two verses, Aparavatta and Puppitaka, are derivations. So they are kinds of Vetaliya also. That means these are in accordance with the Vetaliya rules also. These are in accordance with the Vetaliya rules also. Let's check for Vetaliya rules. Vetaliya pabheda, kinds of Vetaliya. So actually, in Vetaliya section, there were many verses, right? Vetaliya verse was there, and Upachandasaka verse was there, and many other verses were there. So Vetaliya pabheda here says that the previous verse, which was Aparavatta verse, is as same as Vetaliya verse. And this Upitaka verse is as same as Upachandasaka verse, Vetaliya and Upachandasaka. Aparavatta and Upitaka are similar with Vetaliya and Upachandasaka respectively. They are similar with Vetaliya and Upachandasaka respectively. So what was Vetaliya? Vetaliya was Visamecha Siyung Kala Mukhe Sametotta Ralaga Tato Pari. Vetaliyan tamuchate lahu chakkang nanirantaran sami. So the first line, to say it in brief, in the first line there should be six measures in the beginning, and then ralaga should be there. In second line there should be eight syllables in the beginning, and then ralaga should be there, right? Ralaga ragana lahu garu. So here in aparavatta, let's check it. Yadina three narala. So here there are six syllables, right? Six measures, not six syllables. There are six measures in the beginning. Yadina narala, six measures, and then gana ja is ragana, chara is lahugaru. So six measures, and then ralaga are there in the first line. In the second line, there should be eight measures in the beginning. So yadi cha, three ta, four da, six para. So 8 syllables end here. There are, sorry, 8 measures. I'm sorry, 8 measures. 8 measures end here, and then there should be ralaga. Vat mich is ragana. Cha ti is lahu and garu. So after 8 measures, there are lahu and ragana, lahu and garu. So when you repeat these two lines again for compose the full verse, it will be exactly one vetaliya verse. So aparavatta is kind of vetaliya verse. But the difference, if you ask for the difference of vetaliya and this verse, in vetaliya there can be some other ways to compose this verse. Like here there are like in vetaliya verse, the rule was that there should be 6 measures in the beginning, no matter what group, no matter garu or lahu, there should be 6 measures, right? In the second line also, the rule was there should be 8 measures in the beginning, no matter which group is there, no matter garu or lahu is there. But here in aparavatta, the exact groups and heavy garu and lahu syllables that should be there are defined. There should be nagan, na, na, ra, la, ga in the odd lines, and there should be naja, jara in the even lines. So groups and groups and syllables are defined exactly in aparavatta verse, but in vetaliya verse there was not such a limitation. So that is the difference between vetaliya and aparavatta. However, aparavatta verse is always a kind of vetaliya verse. So let's go to a puppitagga verse. So puppitagga is a derivation of upachandasaka. Upachandasaka verse was vetaliyopamang mukhetang upachandasakang raya yadante. That means in upachandasaka verse, the beginning is as same as vetaliya verse, but the end or the cadence should be raya, ragana, and yagana. It is not ralaga, it is raya. Not ragana, lahugaru, it is ragana and yagana. So that is the difference between vetaliya and upachandasaka. So puppitagga verse is upachandasaka verse. Let's check it. Visamma mupaga is the first 6 measures. Visamma mupaga, first 6 measures. Then thana na is ragana. Raya che is yagana. You see? 6 measures, then ragana, yagana are there. In the second line, there should be 8 measures, ragana, yagana, right? According to upachandasaka rules. So, najaja, 3 measures, ra, 4 measures, ga, 6 measures, sama, 8 measures. 8 measures. So, after 8 measures, there should be raya, kecha, pup is ragana, pi, tag, ga is yagana. So after 8 measures, ragana and yagana are there. So when you repeat these two lines again to compose the full puppitagga verse, it is an exact upachandasaka verse. So here also the difference is that in upachandasaka verse, first 6 measures in the odd lines and first 8 measures in the even lines were not defined. But here they are defined. Then they are defined. So that is the difference. So that is what dvayam midang veta, dvaya midang veta liya pabhedo means. Dvaya midang veta liya pabhedo. In Myanmar book, it was dvayam midang. Dvayam midang. M is euphonic according to that. But here M is not euphonic. M is a replacement for nigahita. Here, doyang. So this is the only prose you can see in Vutto there. In whole Vutto there, this is the only prose. All other rules and all are in verse form. They are in verse form. So this is the only prose. This is only prose. This is not a verse, this is a statement. But however, in Sanskrit, in Vrittaratnakara, it is in verse form, right? Here you can see. This statement is in verse form in Vrittaratnakara, but it is not written in accordance with Aparavatta on Pukkitagga rules. It is written in accordance with Vatta rules. However, it is written in verse form. But in Uttodaya, it is not a verse. This is just a statement. This is a sentence. Prose. Yeah, you can see here. The last line, Dvayam idam vetaliya pabhedo, is unmetrical. It is unmetrical, but as we can see from the Sanskrit, it is a translation of a verse in Vrittaratnakara. In Vrittaratnakara, there is a verse, which itself is unusual in being Vatta meter. You see, in Vrittaratnakara also, it is in Vatta meter, it is not in Aparavatta meter or Upitagga meter, it is in Vatta meter, because it is not commentary. It's just a comment for the previous two verses. It's just a comment for the previous two verses. So that is in Vatta meter here, and is a comment on the preceding meters in the text. This is the only line in Uttodaya which is written in prose. You can see. This is the only line in Uttodaya which is written in prose. All other lines are written in verse form. That is the end of Pupitagga verse. Are there any questions? No questions. Then we are moving to the next verse. Next verse. Yeah, this is the end, final verse. Sa yavadika mati raja rajatu same same jara jara garu bhaveyum. Very nice to read. Sa yavadika mati raja rajatu same same jara jara garu bhaveyum. But that meter with yava at the beginning and mati should have ragana jagana in dot lines, and in the even lines jagana ragana and a heavy syllable. So that verse is called as yavadika mati verse which has yava at the beginning. That means yava mati. So yava mati is the name, right? Yava mati is the name. So that is written in yavadika mati, just as same as indadika vajira, right? Indadika Vajira, like it was in the Vajira. Here also, Yavadika Mati is Yavamati. So in Yavamati verse, there should be Raja, Rajatu, Same, Ragana Jagana should be there in Same. So here it is a combination. Succeeding vowel is deleted, right? Asame, this is not Same, this is Asame. Asama is same as Visama, right? Asama and Visama are same. So A is deleted. A is deleted. A is deleted. That's why it is, that's why this apostrophe is there actually. So in Asama, that means in odd lines, there should be Nagana Jagana, Ragana Jagana, Ragana Jagana. And Same, in even lines, there should be Jagana, Ragana, Jagana, Ragana. The odd line is Raja Raja, in even lines Jara Jara, and then Garu, one heavy syllable should also be there. Garu is also it is not plural, it is singular, but U is lengthened. Bhavi Yung, there should be Jagana Ragana Jagana Ragana and one heavy syllable. Let's check it. Sa Yava is Ragana, Dikama is Jagana, Ti Raja is again Ragana. Rajatu is again Jagana. Sami is. Oh, sorry. Jagana. So that is the end of the line. Then in the second line, there should be Jara, Jara, Garu. Sami sa is Jagana. Me Jara is Ragana. Jara ga is Jagana. And again, Rubha Veyi is Ragana. Yung is the Garu. Yung is the heavy syllable. So this is Yavamati verse. Yavamati verse, there are no examples given. Are there any questions?
Yeah, hi Panti.
Yes.
So in the Myanmar version, is it the same as the here, Panti? It's Tusame, Panti. It's also Tusame.
Sayavadika Mati Raja Raja Twa. No. It was Twa. Twa.
Right? Yeah, it should be Twa, right?
Yes, twice better.
Yes, yes.
Because U becomes va, right?
Yes.
U becomes va and when a vowel is following. Vamodu dantana. Vamodu dantana is the sutta. Yeah, yes, yes. TV is better. Twa.
Yes.
Sayavadika mati raja raja twa same same.
Yes. Because then the meter is still the same. So we just move the ta into the previous. This is jat and then wa, right?
Yes.
It should be maybe, much better. Okay, thank you, Pandey.
Okay. So that is the end of the fourth chapter. It is Uttode Chandasi Adda Samavutti Niddesho Nama Chatuttho Parichedo. This is the end of fourth chapter, which is called as Adda Samavutti Niddesho. So there are 11 verses. There were 11 verses and one statement, one prose was also there. So these are the half similar verses shown in Butto there. So next week we are moving to the next chapter, which is Visama Buttari. This is the last chapter which gives introduction, so which presents rules to compose verses. In the sixth chapter, some other things are there. So we are moving to this fifth chapter, Visama Buddhi Nidesa, dissimilar line meters, in the next week. That means within three more discussions, we can finish Butto there. Actually, within two discussions also we can finish. Like for Visamavutti only there are 10 verses in Visamavutti. So we can finish that in one discussion and then sixth chapter in one discussion. But I would like to take two discussions for Visamavutti because there are so many examples. We can take some examples from here and there and examine those verses. So it's better to take two discussions for Visamavutti. Yeah, and then let's conclude. Yes.
Pandit?
Yes.
Why in the Adda Samavutti chapter, we have only the syllables from 10 to 13. So not less than that or more than that. Why?
I have no idea about that.
So that means in the Bali literature, generally if it's come to the Adda Samavutta, so they were not beyond these syllables, the number, or they were not less than those syllables?
Yes, in Pali literature, there are no. Actually, in Pali literature, there are no examples for the shown verses also. Like, you didn't find any example for many verses, right? Only one or two verses, there are examples in Pali literature.
So this two in the Burmese translation, what do they translate?
These two?
Yeah. In the Yavamati.
Yes.
Verse. That two, we say dwa same. So the two, what's the Burmese?
Dwa is translated as, like in the Myanmar, usual Myanmar term we use is Thoma Taba, that means apart from that, like you mention something and when you start the sentence to mention about another thing, new thing, then you can use some particles like tu and pana. Pana is often used in commentary in this meaning. Apart from that, like let's say there is a mentioning about five things: saddha, virya, sati, samadhi, panya. Five things. A list is there. One list is there. Then explanation comes about saddha, and it ends. And then when you start the explanation for virya, in that sentence, after the first word, in most cases, after the first word of that sentence, there is a particle, pana or tu, mostly pana. So that is technically called as pakkhantara. Pakkhantara, that has a meaning of apart from that, or like one is finished explaining, now I move into the next one. So such meaning is included in that particle. So here tu is also often translated as that.
Oh, I see. It's like a bakka and the bakkhantara.
Yes, of course. Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Pandya.
Okay. Then let's conclude the class for today by reciting Buddha Sasanam Chirang Tithatu. Buddha Sasanam Chirang Tithatu. Buddha Sasanam Chirang Tithatu. Buddha Sasanam Chirang Tithatu. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
Thank you, Pante. Saru, saru, saru.
Thank you so much, Pante.
Thank you.